Hey guys, today I've got an AliExpress haul video. I'm going to be showing you a total of 8 items that I've accumulated over the last several months, including 4 handbags and 4 pieces of clothing. At the end of this video, I'm going to be doing an overall review of AliExpress, including the pros and cons. Okay, let's get into the items. Okay, we're gonna start with the handbags, and I've got this, a pretty bad boy here. Yes, it is the dupe for the Chanel boy bag in the chevron print. It's in the old medium size, so it's 20 centimeters by 15 centimeters. I have it in the silver hardware, and it's got the clasp that you just squeeze open, and there it is. The leather is very soft. It's genuine cowskin leather. It's kept up remarkably well. I've had this for a couple of months and there's not that many scratches in the front. There are a couple of scratches in this area here. When you open and close, your fingernails graze on it. I was a little bit nervous buying this handbag because generally when I buy off AliExpress, I make sure there's a lot of reviews. I read them. I look at the ratings and the comments, and the seller here did not actually have any orders. And normally that's not something I would buy, but in this case, because the photos were so well documented and the quality through the photos looked really good, you know, one of the best that I could find, I decided to take a chance on this bag and I was not disappointed. The one downside I would say is that the seller actually sent me the wrong handbag. So it is in the chevron print, which I've come to love, but I did order it in the sort of traditional, you know, quilted pattern. And when I got this, I was disappointed. So I opened up a dispute and I managed to negotiate a 50% discount with the seller. So instead of paying the full $100, I got $50 back. And I have come to actually really like the chevron print. So overall, I am loving this bag. I'm glad that I purchased it, but you know, these things can happen with AliExpress, and your recourse then is to open up a dispute and hopefully negotiate something and get some kind of money back. But they are usually pretty good if you get the wrong item. So I'm very happy with this. Just like the Chanel bag, you can wear this as a crossbody. You can also do this and wear it over your shoulder. Really like this handbag. I kind of wish I would have gotten it in the new medium size. It was just a bit higher because then it would allow me to fit in my sunglasses, but it does serve its purpose for a good sort of everyday day bag if you don't need to bring a lot of items, and then of course at night. So very happy with this purchase. All right, next we have another dupe bag. This is the dupe for the Fendi Peekaboo in the beige. It comes in several colors. I opted for the nice neutral tone. It does come with this scarf separately that you can just tie around if you like, which I did opt to do to give it a bit more elegance and a bit more character as well. It does come with a crossbody adjustable strap, and then of course the top handle, which you can just wear like this if you prefer. The space inside is pretty decent. We've got a card holder right here, and then on the other side, the same amount of space with a zippered pocket just for that extra security for those items. I do like this as an everyday bag. I'm trying to not carry around as many items with me as I normally used to do, so this is a good size bag for just having your everyday essentials. This fits my phone, it fits my little makeup bag and my sunglasses and just a couple of other things, without appearing too bulky, especially when you're wearing it on the crossbody. But I really do like this. I think it's very well made. You know, the only downside I would say is that it is advertised as genuine cowskin leather, and it, to me, it doesn't have the feeling of genuine leather. It is hard to tell though, I have to admit. It does come with a little sample size that you can do the burn test, and it had trouble lighting up, which seems to suggest that it is genuine leather. So it did pass the burn test. I think what it might be is a mix of materials, including genuine leather, or perhaps it's got some cowskin leather with some sort of coating on the top, and that's why it feels synthetic. But having said that, it looks great. I mean, the stitching is wonderful. The hardware is good. Other than the actual material, I really like everything else about this bag. And to be honest, I thought it would bother me that it's not real leather, but but it doesn't. It doesn't bother me. And I don't know that you can really tell from afar anyways. So really happy with this bag. My third bag to show you is another designer dupe. This is the Chloe Faye bag. There are a lot of dupes out there, and this one is really well made. Definitely recommend it. It's genuine leather, and you can tell that it is genuine leather with this one. And it's got this suede material on the top. The hardware, again, really solid and well made. It's gold hardware with the silver part on the buckle, which is the same as the actual Chloe Faye bag, and a lot of people complain about that, but this does look very much like the actual designer bag. Of course, there is no logo on the top, which is what you would see if it was an actual Chloe bag. You do have an adjustable strap here, and it just opens this way. It's got a lot of pockets on the inside, maybe even too many pockets, but again, this is pretty much identical to the actual Chloe Faye bag. I love this purse. I think it's really elegant. It's perfect for a night out. I don't wear it during the day because I just find that it's not quite roomy for my everyday essentials. This bag is so well made, and really, aside from the Chloe logo that you would have embossed here, it looks pretty much identical to the actual designer bag, which is incredible because I think this cost $80. I've got one more handbag to show you. This one is not a designer dupe. This is a black genuine leather croc embossed crossbody bag. I love the croc embossed detail across. It's got this sort of, I guess, crocodile head on the top that just adds that little bit of uniqueness to the bag. I really like that detail. It's got gold hardware. There is a zipper on the back. This, I believe the size was 20 centimeters by 15. So it is relatively spacious, very similar to the Chanel boy bag, actually, in terms of what you can fit inside. It's got more compartments though. There is the zippered part on the inside to add items that you want a bit more secure or a little bit more hidden. But it's got the zipper on the back pocket because I find, you know, for my phone and headphones, I like to have pockets on the exterior of my bags. That way I can just reach for them really quickly, or if you need, you know, your credit card or something like that, if you're out and about, you can just have those easy to reach items inside. Another thing that I'll mention is that it does actually come with a separate strap that I don't have attached at the moment. Let me just show you. Just this strap that you can basically hang on top here and just wear it, you know, over the shoulder like that, or just have it as a sort of top handle. I just leave that inside the bag. I don't know if I'm gonna be using it. I prefer to wear these kind of bags crossbody, but there is that option. The one downside I would say on this bag, which I wish I would have known before purchasing it, is that there's actually no clasp from the flap onto sort of the main body here. So it just kind of flaps open and hangs there. There is a zipper here, so you are able to keep your items secure. But I just find that it kind of just hangs there. It's actually not a huge deal. I don't know if you can really notice, but I just thought, you know, why not just have a clasp to keep it hidden so it's not kind of flapping open, you know, why not just do that? But that is the only downside. I do like this bag. I think it's really unique with this sort of curve on here and the croc embossed, and then of course like the little head is kind of snarky and fun, so I like that. Now let me show you the four items of clothing that I have, starting with this beautiful baby pink chiffon silky top that I've got on here. I absolutely adore this top. It cost $5 or $6 and it's free shipping. I mean, I don't even know how they can afford to ship it over from China to Canada. I'm pretty sure the shipping alone, it's got to cost, you know, double or three times the amount. So anyways, I do absolutely love this top. I love this top so much that I actually went ahead and I ordered it in a champagne color. So really excited to get that in the mail. This item from the seller does take a long time to arrive. I think it was one of the items that took actually the longest, maybe 5 or even 6 weeks. It is coming from China, it's snail mail, so that's, you know, that is something you have to keep in mind with AliExpress, but for $5, it is absolutely worth it. I think this, the quality of the top is Aritzia level quality it is. I mean, I do have a top from Aritzia. Let me just show you. This is a top I got from Aritzia that cost, I don't know, $85 or something. And I absolutely love this top, but I feel this one for $5, I mean, can definitely get away with looking like it's from Aritzia. I think the quality is absolutely comparable. And for $5, that just blows my mind. What I really like about this is there is a higher neckline, so you can wear this to the office with a blazer popped over. What I often find myself doing is actually wearing this underneath a roll neck or some kind of knitwear. If I'm going out and I don't know how hot or cold it's going to be, if I do find myself just heating up a little bit, I'll take off my knitwear and then I'll have this underneath, and it doesn't add very much bulk to the outfit at all. It just looks really clean underneath. I think this is so versatile. It's perfect for spring. I absolutely love this shirt. Let's talk about sizing a little bit, because that is something that you have to keep in mind with AliExpress. It is Asian sizing. So normally I am a medium in Canada and the US. This I bought in a large size. Normally AliExpress, you have to go up two sizes, and the champagne color top I did purchase in XL. I think this fits really well. I think it's meant to be a little bit loose, so I wouldn't mind it being a little bit more loose than it is now. I think this fits me really well, but I'm gonna try the XL just to see how that compares. So just keep that in mind. I would say for this top, just size up, or if you're quite busty, then definitely size two sizes up. Okay, next I've got this sweater dress in a neutral color. It's got a V-neck, which is nice if you don't want to have that bulk on the top or if you want to be layering. It's got these balloon sleeve details on it. It is very soft to the touch. It's a wool and cashmere blend, or it's supposed to be, and this is the other thing you don't really know exactly with AliExpress. They actually don't send invoices, they don't send labels, so you're just trusting what the seller puts on the item description, you know, and whether that is what you're getting or not, it is hard to tell sometimes. So that's what they say, I don't know. Again, I'm a size medium. I ordered this in a large. It does fit, but I wish I would have gotten it in an XL, because then it would have been a bit more flattering. I just think it kind of hugs in the wrong places. If I would have tried this on in a change room, honestly, I wouldn't have purchased it. And this is another downside that I'll get into at the end of the video with AliExpress. If you get something and it doesn't fit quite right, it's very difficult to send it back, because the shipping is going to cost you. In this case, it was going to cost me three times the price of the item, which I believe this was $20 or $25. So it's just not worth it to send it back, and then you're stuck with something. I think I can make this work styled, you know, over a turtleneck or with some accessories. I definitely think I can rock this, but yeah, I don't love it. And I think it's probably because I got it a size too small. Okay, this is my favorite piece of knitwear that I got. Look at this beautiful camel color. I am absolutely in love. It is so soft. Again, it's supposed to be a wool blend. I believe there might be some cashmere in here. It's really soft. It's so lovely. It's really, really high quality. I don't remember exactly how much this cost, but the price will be in the description box below, so click on those links. This is an XL, which is perfect. Definitely go up two sizes with this item. It is quite fitted. It comes pretty much to your hip, which is so great for just tucking it in. It looks really put together. I absolutely adore this. In fact, I would go back to the seller. I would get another one in a different color. I like it so much. I believe the price was pretty reasonable, maybe $30 or $40, I can't exactly remember. This was a really good purchase, absolutely recommend it. Okay, my last piece to show you from AliExpress in this haul is another sweater dress. Again, it's got this kind of cable print in the front. The back is just plain, and it does have this cable knit on the sleeves as well. Sleeves don't go all the way to your wrist, it kind of comes up a little bit short, but that's totally fine. I love this taupe color, I love the material, I like the length of this as well. What I don't like is that it is body conscious as opposed to the more oversized feel. I wish it was a little bit more loose, but it's still, I think, very flattering with some tights and over the knee boots and some accessories. You can definitely style this up. And for the price, I mean, you can't really complain. The price of these things are ridiculous, and the quality is so good for the price that you're getting. So there's definitely a lot of value there. I do like this, don't love it, but still pretty happy with it considering it was so inexpensive. Now I want to quickly go over the pros and cons of AliExpress. Let's start with the pros. You can get some amazing quality pieces for really, really cheap. If you were to buy this stuff in North America, it would cost, you know, twice or three times the price because you're buying it from the factory directly in China. You're getting the wholesale price, and that is the best benefit. There's a wide variety of products. There's tons of colors and all these items that I've showed you. They have almost, I mean, I don't want to say pretty much everything, but they have a lot of stuff. So if you're shopping next time, you know, it's worth taking a look at AliExpress and doing a quick search to see if you can find it for a much cheaper price. The biggest drawback to shopping at AliExpress is that these items are coming directly from the factories in China. So it is snail mail. If you live in North America or even Europe, these items are going to take weeks and weeks to come. The shipping I received with these items was 3 weeks, and the longest I had to wait was 6 weeks. So generally, on average, you could expect to be waiting 4 to 5 weeks per product. That is a long time for people that online shop. They want their things, you know, pretty much right away or as soon as possible. It's a really long time to wait. That's part of the reason why AliExpress is not as popular in Western countries. They do get a lot of traction in countries like Russia and Brazil and Mexico, more developing countries that are willing to wait that long time to get these cheaper pieces. I think a lot of us in Western countries, we just want things right away, and that is a huge drawback. So definitely keep that in mind when shopping at AliExpress. I think AliExpress is perfect for things like handbags, things that don't involve sizing or sizing issues, you know, so perhaps jewelry or accessories, that sort of thing, they are perfect for. Now, if you are wanting to buy clothing there, everything is in Asian sizing. So for me, I'm a medium. I have to go up 2 sizes generally, so an XL. Not everybody wants to be walking around with something that's 2 sizes up, but because it doesn't come with labels, I mean, no one's gonna know that it's in that size. If that's something that bothers you, I'm just throwing it out there. There are no labels or anything attached to any of these items. Definitely look at the item descriptions, look at photos, make sure you're looking at the sizing and that you're doing your own measurements so that you are ordering the correct size. Sometimes, you know, I'm not gonna be going up 2 sizes, I'm just going to be going up 1 size, like in this shirt, for example. And I definitely read the reviews and the comments. People are really good about posting photos of how the items look on them. They're really good about posting their measurements and what size ended up fitting them. Because if you have a sizing issue, it's going to cost a lot of money to send that item back. The other thing is that there is a lot of trust with the sellers. Because these things are not coming with labels, because they are coming from a factory in China, you don't really know exactly what you're going to get. You are trusting the seller to deliver an item based on the description and the advertising that they have put up on the item description. Whether these items have any cashmere or wool or whatever in them, you can kind of go off by the feel, I guess, but you don't really know for certain. And if you're not comfortable with that level of trust, then this might not be the best route to purchase items for you. The other thing I want to mention is AliExpress is a website that puts sellers in touch with buyers directly. So it's not a company on its own. The brand of these products are not AliExpress. They're simply providing the application to connect two parties together. So you're going to be dealing with a lot of different factories and a lot of different companies and a lot of different brands, and there could be quite a lot of inconsistencies between products as a result of that. If you're dealing with returns, you know, you're dealing with individual sellers, not just one main company. AliExpress does have a hand in settling disputes between buyer and seller. So if you receive a product that is different from what was described, you can open a dispute, and AliExpress does weigh into that to make sure that there is some kind of quality control and accountability. Okay, that's my review of AliExpress. Of all the items that I've bought, if I were to have had the opportunity to try these items on, There's only one that I would not have purchased, and that is that beige sweater dress. Everything else I like. I think for the price that I paid, I got amazing value and quality. I would definitely purchase again from AliExpress. I'm overall really impressed with the website and with the different sellers, so I would recommend at least checking it out and maybe buying a few inexpensive things to test it out to see if it's for you or not for you. I hope you guys found this video useful. Let me know in the comments below. Okay, we'll see you next time.